In this problem, we're given the matrix A, 6, minus 2, 6, and minus 1, and we're asked to find the eigenvalues and the eigenvectors of that matrix. Now, the eigenvalues and eigenvectors are scalars lambda, the eigenvalues, and vectors v, the eigenvectors, so that A times v is equal to lambda times v. And we'd like to find those. So we're going to start by finding the eigenvalues, lambda, and we do that as follows. We compute the characteristic polynomial of that matrix, and we find the zeros of the characteristic polynomial. So characteristic polynomial P of lambda is defined as the determinant of the matrix A minus lambda times the identity matrix. So let's compute that. So we get the determinant of the matrix 6 minus lambda minus 2, 6, and minus 1 minus lambda. I'd like to compute the determinant of this. So we get this characteristic polynomial, lambda squared minus 5 lambda plus 6, and we want to find the zeros of that. And so we see that this factors as lambda minus 2. So this matrix has eigenvalues 2 and 3. So now let's compute the eigenvectors for the eigenvalue lambda 1 equal to 2. So we have to find all the non-zero vectors in the kernel of A minus 2 times the identity matrix, where 2 here is that eigenvalue. So this is the kernel of the matrix 4, minus 2, 6, and minus 3. So how do I compute the kernel of a matrix? Well, I solve the linear system, 4, minus 2, 6, minus 3, and 0, 0, because the kernel means exactly those vectors who are mapped to 0, 0 by this matrix. So let's do some row operation. First, I'm going to divide the first row by 2. So this is 2, minus 1, 0, 6, minus 3, and 0. And then let's subtract 3 times the first row from the second row. So 2, minus 1, 0, and 0, 0, 0. Okay, so by looking at this matrix, we can easily see one vector that's in the kernel. For example, 1 and 2. So the kernel of A minus 2i is the span of, for example, the vector 1, 2. And now we know that the eigenvectors corresponding to the eigenvalue lambda 1 are all the non-zero multiples of this vector. So the eigenvectors for lambda 2 are all the t times 1, 2, where t is not 0. Now we'd like to find the eigenvectors for the eigenvalue lambda 2 equal to 3. And we could do it exactly in the same way that we did it for the first eigenvalue, but we're going to do something a bit faster. And we're going to use the fact that we know if all the roots of the characteristic polynomial are distinct, then all the kernels are one-dimensional. So that's exactly the case we're in right here. We've got two distinct eigenvalues, and therefore we know that the corresponding kernels are one-dimensional. So here, for lambda 2 equal to 3, we'd want to look at the kernel of A minus 3 times the identity matrix. So this is the kernel of 3 minus 2, 6, and minus 4. And it's very easy to see, to find a vector in that kernel. Just by looking at the first row, for example, we see that 2 and 3 is a vector. So we know that this will be the span for example, of 2 and 3. And therefore we know that our eigenvectors for lambda 2 will be all the multiples t times 2, 3, where t is not 0.